Hey, playing around. Got the Scancast installed. I think I got the volume to where it's loud enough, but not too loud. I've got it recording over to a USB stick because I don't know how big it's going to be. I can't pause this video on here, so I'm going to be saying the word pause and using that as a marker when I edit it to edit out big chunks of time, because it's going to, you know, take forever, some of this stuff. Anyways, so what I'm going to be doing is installing Linux Mint in one of the partitions I prepared in the previous video. I like to do the secondary distro first, because the last distro installed will take ownership of grub. We'll install grub and take ownership. And in this case, I want that to be Pop OS. Okay, we're going to install the third-party software. I showed you how in a previous video, also in another video, how to write a bootable USB. So you want to, I don't have a video showing how it actually boots up. You need to boot up with a live Mint. This is going to, is version 18.3. Okay, I don't want it to unmount that, because I plan to use that one. That happens to be this one. In your case, or in most people's cases, you would just say yes. You would say unmount everything. Okay, here's where we choose the installation type. Erase disk and install on Mint, encrypt. I don't bother with encrypt because I don't carry my laptop anywhere. And same thing with using logical volume management. I just do something else. We're going to continue. And it takes a little bit to read the drives. Hopefully it will read the drives. And there they are. I put that one single drive in there. So there you see the swap. The 230, roughly 32 gig partitions, and then the big old rest of it partition that we're going to use for home. So we're going to put this on SDA2. So we're going to click on change. We're going to leave the size alone. We're going to say ext4 journaling system. We're going to format the partition. We're going to use just the slash. And then we're going to say OK. It's going to warn us. Oh my god, are you sure you want to do this? Oh, didn't do that. Probably because nothing's there. Now, we're going to use this one. And the first time we do it, we're going to format it. You'll notice that this step is going to be different when we install Pop OS. Sorry for that pause. So we're going to format the partition, and this time we want that to be home. And say OK. And it's ready to go. We want to make sure that this is putting the bootloader, i.e. grub, on /dev/sda. The only drive that's in this laptop. And now we're going to install. By the way, before all this started, I connected to the internet. I connect to the internet first. That's me. I connect to the internet first. It will ask you if you want to connect to the internet, but I've seen that act a little hokey sometimes. So I like connecting to the internet first. I had to connect to the internet first because I had to install some software to videotape this. But it's always a good idea to do that first. Install now. Okay, continue, blah, 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 blah. It automatically found swap. We didn't have to tell it anything about it. Then we're going to continue. Okay, now it's going to ask me, where are you? Sure, Los Angeles, why not? And we're going to use a US keyboard. Okay, now, this is where on Linux Mint, we're going to set up the main user ID. With Pop! OS, it asks the first time you boot it up. So there's a slight difference there. But one thing I want you to remember is when you put two OS's on the same system, you want the username and password to be identical. So, I don't care what the computer name is. This is the only time you're ever going to be allowed to use a short password. You ever add or have to change the user? I like it to log in automatically. Some people are like, oh my gosh, blah, blah, blah. You know what? If it's not leaving the house, if it's always going to be in a secure area, I do log in automatically. You carry a laptop around, you have a habit of leaving it sit there while you go fill up your cup of coffee, you may want to have require my password to log in. You may want to encrypt your hard drive, but for the normal type of user who's just kind of mostly using it at home, okay, this is where I'm going to say pause. Okay, well that kind of jumped up on me. Kind of ran a bit quicker. I was busy looking at something else. Alright, so I'm going to stop the video and I'm going to do a restart now and it'll come back up normally. I don't see any reason to record that part of it coming back up normally. And in fact, I have really no good way of doing that unless I had a camera on it. So, anyways, we're done. Stop the video.